KCRA 3 investigates what's been called the Wine Train Project. More than $60 million set aside to move railroad tracks for the popular Napa Valley train. But did taxpayers spend too much? That work was part of a massive flood control project.
Yeah, but tonight some lawmakers are raising some questions, including two U.S. senators who are calling the project silly and short-sighted.
This train is at the center of a federal flood control project and a controversy over federal tax dollars. The Army Corps of Engineers is just a week away from completing a $65 million project that moved the train's tracks.
We built two new bridges. We demolished an old existing bridge that went over the Napa River, and that was actually like a debris trash.
Dave Cook is with the Army Corps of Engineers. He said they had to remove the old wine train bridge because it was actually creating flooding problems. This bridge, the roads, all were moved 5 to 6 feet higher.
We had the money and we needed to obligate it to get the project moving forward.
The Corps of Engineers said the project was ready to start and awarded the contract to Sulitoc Construction out of Alaska. Because the company is Native American, it was able to get the contract with no competition.
With the stimulus money, there was decisions made to go out and award this as quick as we can. The project was shovel ready, so we followed federal policy and awarded the contract as needed at that time.
I think that's a fig leaf of an excuse, because you can have expedited bidding procedures.
John Kupal with the Howard Jarvis Taxpayers Association disagrees with the Corps of Engineers, saying contracts can be bid quickly and ultimately save taxpayers a lot of money.
It is the way to ensure that you get the best value for the dollar, and we're always troubled when we see these government infrastructure bids go out, these projects go out without any bid at all.
A report issued by Senators John McCain and Tom Coburn echoes that sentiment. The senators point out that the wine train contract cost $10 million more than what typical contractors would have charged. They also point out that Sulitoc had never done construction of this size before.
If you're going to overpay for a bidder or a company, you ought to at least make sure that they're competent in doing what they're doing.
This is a valuable transportation corridor for the county of Napa.
A wine train spokesperson says that their company has faced unwarranted criticism and points out that this is just one phase of a larger flood control project.
And what they didn't realize was the business itself received no money from the federal government.
We would hope that when all is said and done with this project, that even though we overspend for it, that we'll at least have a marginal improvement in flood control.
Now, the wine train project has gone over budget now, costing $79 million. The total flood control project is projected to be over $500 million.